Today we're gonna see how you can create logo reveals, transitions, titles, side infos and lower thirds very easily in Final Cut Pro 10 using the YouTuber pack from Digital Products 669. Hey everybody and welcome back to another Final Cut Pro 10 tutorial. For those of you who are watching me for your first time, I'm Emilio Takas and I post videos here on tutorials, filmmaking tips, gear reviews and much more. So, if you're into this kind of stuff, consider subscribing to my channel and also ring the notification bell to receive notifications every time I post a new video. I wanna give a huge shout out to Digital Product 669 for sponsoring today's episode and I have placed the link for you to get this pack in the description of this video down below. Also, if you're more of an Adobe user, then I have placed a link in the description of this video down below as well for the Adobe version of the YouTuber pack. Now, let's go into Final Cut Pro 10 and see what we can create very easily with this pack. Alright, first things first, you have downloaded the YouTuber pack for Final Cut Pro 10 from Digital Products, and how you're gonna install it. You will see in the file that you see the folders for end screens, logo reveal, lower thirds, side info, and titles. These five folders, you're gonna copy them into movies, motion templates, and titles. And the transitions, you're gonna place them into movies, motion templates, and transitions. Simply as that, a very simple process. And let's go now into Final Cut Pro 10 and see them in the real action. Okay, so we're in the Final Cut Pro 10 interface. As you can see, we have the TYP end screens, logo reveals, lower thirds, side info and titles into our title section here in Final Cut Pro. And let's go and do the logo reveal first. Let's choose the logo reveal 11, for example. We click on it and we go into the effects panel on the right. And as you can see on the first option, we can make the adjustments that we want for colors of the logo, of the background, of the text, the shape accent, etc. As you can see, for example, we can change the logo, let's say to a nice light blue. Here, we can make the first background into a nice light blue as well. The second one to a darker one. And we can leave the gradient into this purple. Now, if you don't have the fonts needed for the titles, the logo reveals, etc., in the file that you have downloaded, here on the Help Documentation folder, if you click on the README PDF, you're gonna find the link for all the necessary fonts that you need to download. So let's continue. Now we have placed the name on the text holder, and here where it says drop zone for the logo, we're gonna place our logo. So we go here, we click here, and we select simply by clicking the left click, but right now you see that you don't see anything. That's because our logo is in a black font, but as you can see here, we will click on the apply clip and everything is gonna work just fine. Simply as that, we have a very nice intro. If you don't have any intro for your videos, your corporate videos or your YouTube videos, and as you can see, we have 20 different options to choose for the logo reveal. Let's go now into the end screen. So, one of the things that a lot of YouTubers or a lot of creators, they don't want or they don't like to spend much time to create is the end screen, and it's a very important aspect of every video. So let's use, for example, the end screen 9 here. We're gonna drag it in the timeline and in the inspector panel again on the effects. Let's move a little bit. We will see that we can adjust again all the colors. For example, you change the color here. Let's leave it to white. We can change, you see on the bottom, the like, comment, subscribe. Let's put it a purple one. And you can either go here and select what element you want, double click on it and change the font here. Or if you're in the inspector panel here, you'll see, for example, title 1, video 1. All right, you can change it to the title of the video, title of video 1. Then the second title here, title of video 2. What's next? You can write, for example, take these, and by clicking enter, it's gonna change the lines on your channel. Again, you can go from here or you can simply double click here. So let's say John Doe again. And then as you're moving down, social media one is the Facebook. And you write whatever your tag is on each of the social media. And that's it. Basically, that's it. And after you finish that and you're ready to export your video, the only thing that you need to do next is enter the YouTube editor. You're gonna place on the end screens the videos right here, so you're gonna have all the border and the background to place your next videos that you want to promote on your end screen of your YouTube video. Let's continue now. Let's say that we have this footage of the tomato and we want to add a side info, something that you probably have seen in a lot of gear reviews. So if you're a YouTuber that does gear reviews, this is something that you're gonna love it. So we go into our titles again, we go into the side info here. We can see that we have 10 different side infos to choose from. Let's go with this one, the side info 8. We're gonna drag it on top of our clip that we want the side info to appear. And text holder 1 is gonna be the title here. This is a tomato. And let's say, for example, what is a tomato? Tomato is the edible, blah, blah, blah. Now, as we can see here in the inspector panel, we can change all the parameters of the text and the titles. So, for example, we can scale all, as you can see here, and we can change the position from here, the X and Y, Z. Basically, it's very familiar and similar for you who are working Final Cut Pro 10 on how we can make any adjustments in the inspector panel. Also on the text holder here, we can change the scale here. And of course, change the X and Y, Z. Let's bring it a little bit to the left. And of course, for the text holder too, again, we can change the scale. And as you can see, automatically, it changes the alignment and the hyphenation. So, something like this. Let's say that we want to change the background to white. And we want to change the text to black text. The color, the first color is a tomato. Let's make it green. And let's play and see. Simply as that, we have a side info for our gear reviews or where we want to make a note for something that we see in our video. Now let's go and see the titles. We go into the titles, the TYP titles. We have 20 titles, 20 different titles to choose from. And let's say that we will go with the first one. Again, we drag it and place it on top of our video. And again, in the inspector panel, we can change all the different parameters, the text of the title and the colors, as you can see here, of the title. Let's do it real quick. John Doe presents. Let's change the yellow to a black one. And boom, title is ready. You can't even imagine how easy it is to create titles, logo reveals, or your lower thirds. Let's go and see a lower third. Okay, we go into titles and we go under lower thirds folder. We have 25 lower thirds to choose from. And let's go and select this one. We go again to the inspector panel here. We will change John Doe. Perfect. And follow us. Create every day. We can change the scale here. Create every day. And if we want to move the whole lower third, we can click here, click on transform, and we can place it, for example, on the bottom right or the bottom left or the top left. Here is, I believe it's great. And let's go. Create every day, John Doe. And of course, we can go into the inspector panel again, click here and change all the colors to the colors that we want to have. And now, one extra thing that you will get with this YouTuber pack is transitions. So, you have end screens, you have logo reveals, you have the lower thirds, you have the side info, you have the titles, and you have transitions. You have 15 transitions to choose from, and you simply use them as you use transitions in Final Cut Pro 10. Let's place one transition here, coming up. And of course, you can change all the parameters again in the inspector panel. Instead of coming up, you can place whatever you want. You can change the logo, the background, and everything that you'll see in these transitions. As you can see here, we have the logos that you can change and all the colors. Very easy to use and very usable. I hope you found this video helpful, and if you did, don't forget to hit the like button, as it helps a lot to rank this video. And if you have any questions about this pack, I'm waiting for them in the comment section down below. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video.